Welcome back to our final day of VBS. I know, it's so sad, but all good things must come to an end. Eventually, all construction projects are finished. And like that, today we are closing out with our last day of VBS. But don't have any tears. Don't cry about it. It's okay, because the church goes on. Church still happens even after VBS. And I encourage you all, if you want to try us out as a church, if you've never been here before, we would love to see you on a Sunday morning and get to know you in person. And if you've been somebody who say, hey, I go to that church, we'd love to see you back eventually as well. And once things clear up and once everything's okay, we would love to see you all again in person. And I'm really glad for today as well, because we're going to be talking about our final foundation. And it's an important one. It's the foundation of life. It's the life that we've built off of when we build off of Christ. When we build off the foundation of Jesus, we have this foundation for our life as well. And so we've got some awesome things. We're closing out with our music. We've got another craft for you. We've got another Bible story. We've got some amazing things playing for today. And so I hope you are paying attention. And if you need to rewind or stop or pause or anything else, that's okay. That's what the power of technology is here for. So we're gonna go ahead and get started with our day, and I hope you have a wonderful time.
Hi, I'm Rachel. Welcome back to the crafting table. And today for our craft, we are going to be building. So you should have some blocks with you. And since today's focus is on building your life on the foundation of Jesus, we're gonna try and build something. So you can build whatever you want, but today I'm going to try and build a cross. So there I have built my cross, and again, you can build whatever you'd like. You can mess around with these blocks and make all kinds of different things, but every time that you see your blocks or play with them, you can remember to build your life on the foundation of Jesus.
Well, Zach, what are we doing out here?
Well, today, we thought we would go out with a bang for VBS, and so we've saved the best for last.
I think so.
Yeah, it's gonna be, you know, explosive. You know, that's the best way to end VBS, and so that's how we're gonna go out today.
We hope you had a wonderful week. We still got a little bit after this as well, but, you know, the best part of construction is, like we said, the deconstruction. And what better way to deconstruct than to demolish?
He's right. We're going to demolish real good today.
All right. So if you will count down with us, we're going to start from three, and then we're going to work our way down. So, ready?
Wait. Hearing protection.
There we go. We need our protection.
All right. Ready?
Yes, sir. In three, two, one.
Hello and welcome to our Vacation Bible School. This is our last day for Vacation Bible School, and we're talking about our theme today is the foundation for life. And Olivia's going to hold that for me, I think. What we're going to be talking about today is making wise decisions or foolish decisions. And I have some situations here that I'm going to read off, and we're going to decide if it's a wise choice or a foolish choice. And the first one is, walk in the rain without an umbrella. Is that a wise choice or a foolish choice? I think it's foolish. How about you all? What about if you walk at a construction site, kind of like we got here, without your hard hat on? Is that foolish or wise? That's foolish, isn't it? Yes. What about if you decide you want to build a house, but you're just going to use glue? You're not going to use nails. You're just going to glue your house together. Is that a wise choice or a foolish choice? That'd be a foolish choice, wouldn't it? Yeah, I think so too. What if you wanted to build a house on a mountain? That would be a pretty wise choice. But if you wanted to build a house in the swamp, how would that go? I don't think I want a house in the swamp. I think that's a bad decision, don't you all? So today, that's what we're going to be talking about, is making wise and unwise choices. And our scripture today, our Bible verses, is in Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 through 29. And if you're familiar with your Bible, there's two parts of the Bible. There's the Old Testament and the New Testament. And Matthew is in the New Testament, and it's really easy to find because it's the first book. So if you want to read these verses or look them up later, all you got to do is go to the Bible, turn to the New Testament, and Matthew's right there for you. And you can find it and read it. And so Jesus used parables when he was teaching to people. And a parable is just a story. It's just a sort of simplified story that he used to teach the people so that they could better understand what he was trying to teach them and help them to learn what he wanted to learn. And so it's called a parable, but it's basically a story. And so he uses a story in Matthew about two men and how they build their foundations. And what he's talking to them, he says that everyone who listens to him, Jesus, who listens to Jesus and abides in him and obeys him, they have a strong foundation. And it's like the man who built his house on a rock. He built his house on the rock, and then when the storms came, the wind and the rain and everything, his house stood because it was on that firm stone foundation. But then Jesus goes on to say, if you hear my word, but you don't abide in my word, and you don't pay attention to my word, you don't obey it, and you just go out and you do what you want to do, whatever you like, whatever feels good to you, then you're like the man, the foolish man, who built his house on sand. And when he built his house on the sand, well then, when the rain came and the wind, the water came up and the sand just sort of gave way and the house just collapsed, fell away. And so that's what happens when we don't listen to God and listen to his word. We do not have that strong foundation. And that's why it's so important that we listen to him and obey him and do what he wants us to do. That gives us that strong foundation. So when we have storms in our life, we're able to deal with them. We're able to work through them and handle them. Whereas if we don't, then it's very hard. And at that time, then's when we probably make a lot of foolish choices and decisions, when we don't have that firm foundation and we don't seek God's guidance first. So I don't know about you all, but I'm really thankful that I do have that strong foundation. And the way to do that is to spend time reading your Bible. Learn what Jesus wants you to do and pray. Pray about things, and that gives you that foundation that you need. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Amy. It's Music and Movement. I'll be teaching you the theme song to this year's VBS, Concrete and Cranes. Each day this week, I'll guide you through the moves for each part of the song. The part of the song that we're going to learn tonight is my favorite because it is, word for word, the theme verse for VBS this week, Philippians 1:6. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. From the chorus going into the bridge, you're going to lean to the left, and then lean to the right, and then start by pulling your hands to the heart. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion. On completion, you're going to spin in a circle. Then we do that again, hands on your heart. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion. Then we say, until the day of Christ, we're going to do a big circle, and then Jesus, a big windmill. So until the day of Christ, Jesus. Then we'll go back to the chorus. We sing the chorus two more times to end the song. And you end the song by holding that pose at the end of the last Concrete and Cranes. Now let's put everything together.
Construction has begun. Rivets and ratchets.
hello. Welcome to the last night of VBS. Our missions moment for tonight looks a little bit different. As you can see, things are not here. Decorations are no longer behind me. I'm not in any kind of snazzy attire or anything like that. But for tonight, our missions moment is actually going to focus on you. Your job now is to fill the next missions moment. And the way you can do that is by living your life. Living your life for Christ and actually seeking missions opportunities within your life. So you've heard over this last few nights, people who have either gone out of the country or people who are working right here in Shelby County as well. It's important for you all to know that missions can happen anywhere with anyone. All it takes is having a relationship with the Lord. And if you've got that, then you have everything you need to be a missionary in your community. And so I want to encourage you to do that. And so for this missions moment, I want to encourage you to start sharing your faith. And sharing your faith with your family, your friends, anyone who will listen, really. It's important for you to do this because that's something that God commands us to do, as we talked about before in our Foundation of Promise the other night. This great commandment that God has given us, that Jesus did as he left this earth, his last thing that he told us was to go forth into all the nations. Proclaim the gospel, teach everyone, let them know about this amazing truth. And so for you all, I really hope that you do that. I really hope that you would share your faith. You can do that in a few ways. You can, number one, tell people about God. Tell them about his love, the relationship that you have with him, all these amazing things that you know about him. Just tell people until they get annoyed, you know? It's an amazing thing to do, to share about your faith with the Lord. Number two, you can share your favorite scripture. Say that you were reading the Bible the other night, or your mom or your dad was reading it to you, and you heard an amazing Bible story. Let somebody know. You know, we talk about our favorite movies, our favorite books, our favorite songs. Talk about our favorite Bible verse with people. That would be an amazing thing to do. And lastly, just live for your life for Christ. God has granted you with this relationship with him. He's given you this foundation of that we've talked about this week to build your life off of. And so we want you to use that for his glory. We want you to make much of God. And what that means is to live for him with your life. And so I hope you do that. I hope you take this missions moment for you and you have it used to bring...
It's okay, keep going.
I hope you take this missions moment to use for the glory of God and use it so he is made high on his throne. Now, that sounds weird. I hope you take this missions moment for what it is. An opportunity to glorify God with your life. So as you go out, as we close out from VBS, which I know is sad, and you know, it's sad we're getting out of this week, but life still happens outside of VBS. That's when most of life happens, actually. And so I hope you use your life to glorify God with everything that you have. So thank you so much for VBS, and we're going to close out with our next segment. I hope you had a wonderful day today with day number 5, with us closing out. I know we had a wonderful week putting all this together and having all of our teachers, our music, our craft, our mission partners, our wrecking crew especially had a wonderful job doing all that. And so I hope you had a great time as well. We have so many more things we want to talk about. We have so many more things we would love to do, and we would love to see you all in the future to do those things. To, you know, have laughs together, to cry together if we need to learn together, and we get to worship God together. And so I hope we get to do that one day in the future. We don't know when things are going to go back to normal, but we are trusting God through it all because we have built our life off of these foundations. We have this foundation of life that doesn't matter if we're in quarantine or not. We are always in Christ. We are always seeking after God for our life. Just like today, when we learned about the wise and foolish builders, we got to talk about not only hearing about Jesus, but living for Jesus as well. And that is not dependent on life circumstance. We constantly live for Christ in everything that we do. And I hope you will as well. And if you've never had a relationship with Christ, if you've never really said that, yes, I believe in Jesus, we especially would love to talk to you about that. And if maybe during this week, for the first time, You said, I believe. Man, we would love to talk to you. And you can reach us, tell your parents to get a hold of us here at the church, and we would love to talk to you about those things. So I'm going to close this out in prayer, and we're going to have a great evening. God, thank you so much for this foundation. For the foundation of our life, Lord, is built on you, for you are the solid rock. God, our house will not be shaken. Our house will not be torn down, Lord, because we can weather any storm. We can go through this life because we have built our life on you. God, we are so very thankful for your son and his sacrifice on the cross, Lord, and that we can have a relationship with you because of that. Lord, I pray that if there's anyone out there who is thinking about a relationship with you, God, that they would act on that, that they would ask someone, they would ask their parents, or they would ask us here at the church as well, Lord, about what that means. God, we are so very grateful for everything that you've done in our life, everything that you're doing right now, even in the midst of this, and what you will do in the future, Lord. God, we thank you and we love you, and it's your name that we do pray. Amen. Thank you all, and have a wonderful week.